Okay, so we are ready now to begin our project in which we will create two Unreal Console commands. These commands will be start anim and end anim, and they will start and stop a matinee sequence in Kismet. I'm going to be coding our classes in the Microsoft Visual Studio Editor with the nFringe plugin installed. I'm not going to explain the details on how to install and configure Visual Studio with nFringe. There are many tutorials available that explain how to do that already, both video tutorials and text-based tutorials. Instead, I'm just going to right away start coding our classes. There are going to be two of them. The first class is going to define the Kismet event node. That is, we are going to create a class that will allow us to add a new type of event node to Kismet, a new node that any level designer can drag and drop and use in the Kismet graph. You will notice here in the Solution Explorer that I have created a folder called Test Classes, and this folder will be used to contain all of the classes, the two classes, that we are going to be adding to this project. So to add a new class, if I right-click on the Classes folder and select Add New Item from the context menu, or I could press Control Shift A on the keyboard. Doing this will display the Add New Item dialog, and from this dialog, I want to select the Kismet event option in the list here, since I'm going to be adding a new Kismet event. I'm going to name this event My Custom Event, and then press the Add button at the bottom right-hand side of the dialog here. And what this will show me is a new source file, and the class that is being created here is already named My Custom Event, and it derives from or extends from the class Sequence Event. Now, this means that my custom event class will inherit all of the functionality that is built into Sequence Event, and in fact, all Kismet events will derive from the class Sequence Event. That is what it means to be an event, that it is a class that derives from this class Sequence Event. There are a number of properties, default properties, defined for this class, namely object name and object category. Object name defines the name of the Kismet event as it will appear in the Kismet editor. You might recall that each and every event in the Kismet editor has its own name displayed in the title section of the node. And defining this object name will define the name for that Kismet event. So I'm going to call it My Custom Event, but I'm just going to add some spaces there to improve readability. The object category variable, this defines the menu item under which my event will be categorized. That is the menu item from the menu that appears in the Kismet editor. Whenever a user right-clicks in the Kismet graph, a menu appears from which we can add all kinds of event nodes, and this variable just defines the menu option under which the event node will be categorized. So I'm going to name this My Events. Okay, now there are some other properties that we want to add or define for this Kismet event. And if we just think for a moment about the kinds of additional properties that events have, we will understand the various properties we must add. Now, you might recall that a standard Kismet node contains input connections. These are usually listed on the left-hand side of the node. They contain variable connections, which are listed at the bottom of the node, and they contain output connections, which are listed at the right-hand side of the node. So they contain inputs, variables, and output connections. We need to define the connections that are going to apply to our Kismet event. Now, most events don't have input connections. The purpose of an event is to activate behavior, to initiate new behavior. So they rarely have input connections, rather particular output connections on events are fired. So this means that our Kismet event will not contain any input connections at all. So to begin with, let's return to the default properties block, and we're going to type in the statement input links dot empty. And what this does is it takes this input links array and it empties it. The input links array represents all the input links, all the input connections for our event node, and it makes sure that we empty that array. So now our node has no input links. We don't want any variable links either for our particular event node. Some event nodes might contain variable links, but our event node will not. So I'm going to type variable links dot empty to empty out all the variable links as well. Now, our event node does contain output links. In particular, it contains two output links, play and stop. The first thing I want to do is to empty all the output links as well to make sure that there are no default output links being carried over from the sequence event class, being inherited from that class. And then I want to add my two play and stop output links. So I'm going to type output links. And the first element in the array will equal link desk. And here I can type the name of the output link. The first output link is going to be play. Then I'm going to define the next output link, the second item in the array. And I'm going to name this stop. And there we have added, oh, there's an error here. I haven't put a closing quotation on play. Let's add that here. So now we have defined the fact that our Kismet event node will contain no input links, no variable links, and will contain two output links named play and stop. But there is an additional property that we must also define, and it is this property, bPlayerOnly equals false. Now, the playerOnly Boolean variable, what this tells the event node is how it can be activated. If player only is true, that means that the event can be activated only by the player. If player only is false, then it means that the event node can be activated by all kinds of other causes besides the player. In short, we want the player only variable to be false. If player only is true, then it means that we will not be able to activate any of the output nodes on our event, play or stop, from Unreal Script. It would mean that the only kind of thing that could activate our event would be the player. And that might be fine in some circumstances, but with the work that we want to do here, it is important that we are able to activate the event from Unreal Script. Therefore, you must make sure that the player only variable is false. And now we have created the entirety of our event node. This is everything that we need to create our custom event. If we want this to appear in Kismet, all we have to do is to compile this code using the Unreal Script compiler and then go into the UDK editor and test out in Unreal Kismet the menu options and add our event node to the Kismet graph. So that completes our event class. I recommend that you follow along with this and try it out for yourself. The next class that we're going to create will be the class that will contain all of the functionality that we need to handle the Unreal Script console commands and to initiate or activate this event.